Hello friends, in this video I will be helping you with how to convert a finite automata into a regular expression in easiest way possible using Arden's theorem. So how we'll be doing that, do watch the video till end and you will be fully clear about it, okay? So let's start with it. So this is our, you can say, state diagram, and in this state there are three number of states, that is q1, q2 and q3, right? Now next thing you need to see is, can you notice the incoming edges to all the particular states? Okay, let's see for Q1. For Q1, only one incoming, you can say, edge, that is Q10, right? For Q2, there are two, that is Q11 and Q21, right? And for Q3, there are three incoming edges, that is Q20 and Q30 and Q31, right? You're clear with that? Now you need to see which are your final and initial state, okay? Your initial state is Q1 and your final state is Q1 and Q2. Okay, these are the basic thing you should be aware of when you're using Arden's theorem. So now let's start with the application of Arden's theorem, how to apply the Arden's theorem, okay? So what you'll do is, you'll see the incoming edges to all the states, okay? So let's start with the initial state, that is Q1. Now one thing, there is a one rule of Arden's theorem, that whatever is your initial state, in this case Q1, you will add null to it, okay? You'll start with null and then you'll see the incoming edge. So because Q1 was our initial state, we added null to it, and the incoming edge towards Q1, that is Q10. Okay, same thing we'll do for Q2 as well. So on Q2, the incoming edge was Q11 and Q21, right? Q11 and Q21. Same thing we'll do for Q3 as well. For Q3, the incoming edge was Q20 and Q30 and Q31, right? Same thing we did. So in this, nothing tough. Now what we'll do is, we need to find out the regular expression. Now the question arises that how many regular expression we have to derive. We have to derive that much regular expression, the number of final states are there, okay? If there are two final states, we'll find out two regular expression. If there are three, then we'll find out three regular expression. And if there are one, we'll find out one. So in this case, there are two final states. So we'll find out two regular expression. Okay, so let's start with first one. That is about this one. Okay, so let's pick this equation, that is q1 plus q10. So what we need to see is, we need to check, is this equation linear? That means, does it contains any other state? Like, it might contain q2 here, right? In this case it contains q1, but if it had q2, then we would have picked values from here and we would have put in this one, so to make it linear, okay? So because it is linear from before only, what we'll do is, we'll directly go with Arden's theorem. So our Arden's theorem states that r is equals to q plus rp. If the equation is in form like this, then it can be written as, or it has a solution as, r equals to qp asterisk, okay? So we'll see, we'll take r as q1 and q as null, and again r as q1 and our p as 0. So yeah, it is forming that equation. So we can directly write it as our, you can say, equation, right? So our equation was q1 is equals to qp asterisk, okay? That is q is null and p asterisk, that is 0 asterisk. Now null multiplied with anything will be equal to that thing, so it can be written as 0 asterisk. So for one final state, that is q1, you have taken out. Now you have to take out for another final state, that is q2, okay? So now let's pick this equation, that is q2. So we'll pick this equation q2, q11 and q21, okay? Once you pick this equation, what you need to see is this equation linear? We can see this equation is not linear because it contains more than one number of states, right? So we'll try to make it linear. How we can do that? Either way is, what is one way that we can put value of q1 in this and we try to make it linear, but that won't be possible. But because we had found it, the value of q1 earlier, or the regular expression of the state q1 earlier, we can directly insert it over here and we can make it linear, so that it doesn't contain multiple state, okay? So we'll just put the value of q1, that is our q0 asterisk, and other as it is. Now the equation have become linear, right? Now again we'll do the same thing which we did before. We'll match it with our equation, that is R equals to Q P asterisk. Okay, so yeah, it is matching with that equation, right? So we can write it as R is equals to Q P asterisk, right? So our Q was Q in our other in up case was 0 asterisk 1 and P was 1. So what we'll do is we'll just put 1 and we'll just put inside, and that is 1 asterisk. So it will form like this, or if we simplify it, it will be like this, right? Now because one is included in one asterisk, so because of the values of because of the you can say regular expression properties, we can just write it as one asterisk. Okay, because one asterisk involves one also in it, so it will be 0 asterisk and 1 asterisk. So this is our second equation. Now is this the final answer? No. Now we need to combine, or you can say add both the equation, that is equation number 1 and equation number 2, that is equation number 1 was 0 asterisk and equation number 2 was 0 asterisk and 1 asterisk. So we'll try to simplify it. Can we simplify it? Yeah, we can simplify it. We can take it as 0 as common, 0 asterisk as common, so it will be null plus 1 asterisk.